Hi everyone, it's Simone Watson. I've been talking a lot and really need to rest my voice, so I'm going to give myself 3 minutes to talk about the very basics of your query synopsis and first chapter. What you're going to need if you're going to either enter contests like Pitch Wars or, more importantly, query. Or, I mean, more importantly, depending on how your where your priorities fall, but you know what I'm saying. So, if you are a querying future author, here are some things you need to know in 3 minutes. Okay, so with your query, you want to give us 5 points of information, which are 5 turning points. Well, you need a setup, but then you need 5 turning points. Think of a pendulum and think of your protagonist. Pendulum swings this way, protagonist pushes it this way. So this is when an obstacle comes or something happens that's, you know, negative. This, when the protagonist pushes away, is when the protagonist makes a decision or responds to what's happening. So you need 5 swings of the pendulum. You could do 3, but don't ever do an even number, okay? So you need thing happens, protagonist decides. Thing happens, protagonist decides. And then you need another thing happening, and you need to tell us what does your protagonist need to do. Don't tell us the protagonist's response to this third swing. Just tell us the protagonist's goal during this third swing. So how are we going to stop this other bad thing that's happening? Okay, how is the protagonist going to stop that? Or how should they, how must they stop that? Tell us what the goal is. Don't tell us what actually happens. So you have that swing, 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 swing. And there you go, you got a good query. Once you know what those 5 points are that you need to list, then you go ahead and write it and try and add the voice and all those kinds of things. Next, we want to talk about your synopsis. Don't be cute in your synopsis, okay? Be cute in your query. This means have voice, have some, you know, leave some things vague, you know, leave some surprises. But don't do this in your synopsis. We don't want any vague things in your synopsis. We want to know exactly what happens. That's it. And there doesn't need to be any voice. Don't be fancy. Just say exactly what happens. Spoil it. Spoil, spoil, spoil. Give us the ending. Be exact. Next, your first chapter. How much time do I have? No idea. Okay, I have over a minute left. That's good. So about your first chapter. Now, when we open your novel on the first page, you want to have your protagonist doing something that they care about, that they really care about, because you want an emotion there so that we can get some kind of sympathy or empathy with the main character. So for example, if your main character is at work at a fast food joint after school, you know, maybe they're like, I'm so sweaty and kind of covered in grease and I feel gross and I want to go home so that I can, you know, get ready for my date tonight or whatever. So emphasize that this character feels that way about being here and show us that. Don't just tell us that, but you know, show us what your main character feels. Now then, your first chapter needs to have a beginning, middle, and end. The character should end at a different place from the beginning, and you really should have like a mini, yeah, like a mini story in there. So there needs to be like an inciting incident of your first chapter, but you don't need to right off the bat give us the inciting incident of the whole novel. So just give us like a little tidbit, beginning, middle, and end. And then by the end of the first chapter, there's something to push us into the rest of the novel. You don't have to have your inciting incident already, but you could have like some reason that we're gonna keep reading. Also note this, your first chapter should answer at least one question, and it should raise at least one more question. Meaning, we wanna wonder what the protagonist will do next in response to the events of the first chapter, but we want an answer at the ending of that arc. Okay, so I did go a little bit over 3 minutes, but thank you. I am hoping to do a whole course on Skillshare about querying that will go into more detail on these things, but these were just the little bitty kind of like essentials that I could condense. Okay, so thank you for watching, and if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments.